Where do you keep your railway layout? There are good places and there are bad places. The garage door, well, not maybe the ideal place, but then finding the ideal place is not easy. How about the loft? Well, it's always a bit of a hassle. You've got to get up and down and you've got to bring everything that you're using to make the layout up a ladder into your loft, which, whoops, if it's anything like mine, is pretty much stuffed full of stuff, and in the middle is a dirt great water tank, and that doesn't help. But you can have room for about a 16 foot layout. Now, I made this layout back in about 2008 with the intention of being able to store it easily in a shed and carry it in a small vehicle. The layout itself actually is just 12 inches wide. And when I said to people that I wanted to get 6 tracks on it, I was told that could be just impossible. Well, it didn't work out that way, but it is tight, I will admit. And here you end up with a 12 foot more or less scenic part between the rafters, ended in a fiddle yard box, which never gets used now it's in the loft. It's used for storage, but at an exhibition the idea was you can change a cassette, bring something in on one cassette, slide another cassette in and take something out. Proved very awkward, and certainly in the loft won't work. Scenically, it used to have a village, or at least a street of a village, on the top to try to give the layout some feeling of height. But generally speaking, this is just over 12 foot, 12 inches wide by 12 foot long, 6 tracks giving me some siding space, and then it goes into just the 2 access tracks that run into the fiddle yard. So has it worked? Yeah, it's worked very, very well. It'll have to stay up here, but you do get all the problems with a loft. Hot in the summer, cold in the winter, humidity that is very unpredictable, and that can sometimes muck up slow running for certain locomotives. It was designed to use some DMUs in and out of the station, and enough siding space to be able to play trains. There used to be a bit on the side, which is where that line used to go, that bolted on the side. Unfortunately, practicalities are, you just can't fit that in the loft, so that has had to be abandoned. It was a spur with some oil tanks. The track opened up to 2 tracks just after the curve here. And just for the hell of it, because it was built on 2 6-foot by 1-foot wide planks, I called it 2 short planks. It's great fun. I do use it quite a lot. But how much longer will a man getting into his 80s be able to continue getting up and down? I don't know. That is beyond me. And hidden at the back there, with a little bit of sky above the chimneys, is the street that was on top of the fiddle yard box. So yeah, that is my loft layout called Two